This
ஏய்
conference
சுனில்
will
சொல்ற
now be
ரெஸ்பான்ஸ்
recorded.
ஏன் அடுத்து நான் மை அம்மா ஆடிபிள்
எஸ் சார்.
ஓகே ఏం జ్యోతి ప్రకాష్ మిగతా వాళ్ళు ఎవరు రిప్లై చేయట్లేదు
సార్ జాయిన్ అవుతున్నారు సార్ అందరు.
ఇంకా జాయినింగ్ ఇంకా ఏం జాయినింగ్ బాబు 104 మెంబర్స్ ఉన్నారు సో వాట్ అబౌట్ ఆల్ దీస్ వన్ ఓకే మోహిత్ భూషణ్ హూ ఈజ్ రోల్ నెంబర్ 38
సార్ ప్రెసెంట్
వెరీ గుడ్ బ్రో సింపుల్ గా పోయిన క్లాస్ లో మనం ఆర్సీహెచ్ గురించి ఏమేం చెప్పినామో కొంచెం సినాప్సిస్ ఒక రెండు పాయింట్లు చెప్పు సో వాట్ ఆర్ ఆల్ ద ప్రీవియస్ థింగ్స్ వీ హ్యావ్ బీన్ టాకింగ్ అబౌట్ దిస్ రీప్రొడక్టివ్ అండ్ చైల్డ్ హెల్త్ ప్రోగ్రామ్ ప్లీజ్ గివ్ టూ ఆర్ త్రీ సినాప్సిస్ Now you can message. Yes. What are all the main objectives of RCH program? Anyone? Objectives of RCH. What are all the things that are going to be included? I told you to remember certain terminological words. ఏంటి ఎవరు మాట్లాడరు రోల్ నెంబర్ 40 సిరి 2 సాయి సుమంత్ 111 తులసి Okay, Isha Reddy is saying that to reduce maternal mortality rate and infant mortality rate. Very good, my Isha. Very good. Then, అందుకే చదవమని చెప్పాను. ఒక్కరు చదవరు, ఒక్కరు రెస్పాండ్ ఇవ్వరు. I told you to remember all these things. Just follow. Okay. This is all regarding components. So the main components were these. Family planning, child survival and safe motherhood, that is the CSSM. The short form for CSSM is child survival and safe motherhood. And the prevention and management of RTS, STDs and AIDS, adolescent health care and family life education, client approach to the health care. So this has been also indulo cheptan ma visible ppt visible avutunduga
yes sir
yeah very good So we talked about all the definition. So this is the historical perspective. I told you to remember what are all the components of RCH program. Just now, as we discussed, CSSM, management of RTS and STDs, maternal care. Okay. So it should be client-centered, demand-driven. High quality and it should be integrated and based on the needs of the community. Okay, decentralized participatory planning. I told that decentralization also. Target free approach. So, what are all the previous approaches? What are all the new approaches? So this is also we discussed. This is the present slide is about a vicious circle. At any point of time, we have to intervene and treat the unhealthy female person, then only they will become healthy child, then only they will become healthy adolescent, then only they will become healthy during reproductive period and during pregnancy, so that the female person will deliver a healthy child. It's a vicious circle. So national population policy goals also we have been discussed. So we have to decrease MMR to this much, IMR to this much, 80% nowadays, 100% institutional delivery, 100% by trained person, and 100% of the registrations. Okay, all these things we discussed. Yeah, Gayatri asked about this ISM. Till now I didn't get one. I will tell you, I will get back to you again, don't worry. So these are all the modes of interventions, how we have to be intervened during this RCH. So that should be child survival, safe motherhood, all these things, all the things we have been discussed. So we talked about essential obstetrical care, emergency obstetrical care. So what are all the things which have been included under essential obstetrical care? Anyone? Essential obstetrical care. So what are all the things which have been included under that? Yes? Anyone? Yes, how many antenatal visits? How many postnatal visits? Yeah, antenatal visits, very good. ANC, 4 visits, very good. Ma Isha, and very good. Anjum, good. Then, PNC also 4 visits. Yeah, very good. Okay, very good. At least someone is remembering. So please do read about essential obstetrical care and emergency obstetrical care. Then only you will get to know all the things about RCH program. Yes, this is the one, early registration, that is 12 to 16. Early registration. So 3 antenatal checkups, provision of safe delivery, and 3 postnatal checkups. I already told you clean practices, 5 C's. Clean surface, clean hands, clean blade, clean tie, and clean cot care. Then only you will be able to decrease the postnatal complications regarding all these things. Okay, if you maintain all these 5 C's, 5 clean practices, then postnatal complications like infection, all the infections can be cleared out. So these are all the child survival interventions like essential newborn care. So what are all the essential newborn care? Tell me some. Have you ever been to pediatric ward? Yes? Seventh semester. I think you people have been to pediatric ward. So what are all the essential newborn things we have to be taken care of whenever a newborn is delivered in a delivery table, chapel. Yes. Roll number 124. Breastfeeding. Isha, breastfeeding. Okay, we will take essential newborn care means. After delivering the baby, we have to take certain precautions or certain things we have to clean up to take care of the newborn. Okay, breastfeeding is always essential. Yeah, very good, Anjum. Oral suction, not only oral, both nasal and oral, both. Yeah, then, so what are all the things you people have been to be taken care of a newborn. A baby is just delivered from the womb. So you have separated the placenta also, you have tied. Then what you people have to do with the newborn baby? Okay, first you will suction this koni, okay, oral suction, nose and nasal suction, okay, everything is done. After that, yeah, very good, cord must not be cut until it stop pulsating. Very good, very good. This thing will save the baby, okay, until the cord pulsating thing stops, then only we have to cut the cord. Very good. Why? Because so that the baby will get more blood from the mother, at least 5 to 10 ml, very very vital for newborn. Okay, then yeah, very good, 10 ml extra blood, very good. We have to take care of everything. First we have to clean up the baby under lukewarm water. We have to, yeah, very good, wrap the baby to prevent hypothermia. Very good, Raviji. We have to wrap the baby. First we have to clean the baby. Yeah, very good. Eye cleaning is also very very essential care. After a suction, eye should be clean, hair should be clean, all the parts should be clean, and the baby should be wrapped in a clean and sterilized towel. Okay, yeah, very good, Apgar score, very good. We have to take the Apgar score. What do you mean? What are all the things which have been included in Apgar? Apgar roll number 128, till that person not replied. I'm marking option for him. Who is roll number 128? Who is roll number 124 and 128? So I'm making absent. ఎవరెవరైతే నాకు రిప్లై ఇవ్వట్లేదు అందరికి ఆప్షన్ వేస్తున్నానమ్మా మీ ఇష్టం. తర్వాత ఐ డోంట్ నో వెదర్ పీపుల్ ఆర్ లిజనింగ్ ఆర్ నాట్, ఆప్షన్ వేస్తారన్నా గుర్తుపడతారు. యా వెరీ గుడ్ రైస్. స్కిన్ కలర్, పల్స్, రెస్పిరేటర్ రేట్, మజిల్ టోన్ అండ్ హార్ట్ రేట్. Apgar score, very good. We have to take care. Okay, very good. Whether respiratory rate is good or not. Okay. Whether the child cried or not. Yeah, reflexes. Yeah, reflexes is also one of the important one. Those are all the things. Hello, which sir. Have been included under essential newborn care. Exclusive breastfeeding. Yavaru?
Sir, Pilchar, sir, 124.
ఎప్పుడు పిలిచాను నాన్న, గంట క్రితం పిలిచా. ఎసెన్షియల్ న్యూ బార్న్ కేర్ ఏంటి అని అడిగా, ఇంతవరకు రిప్లై ఇవ్వలా నువ్వు. నాట్ త్రూ మెసేజెస్ ఆర్ నాట్ బై ఓవరాల్ ఆల్సో యు డిడెంట్ రిప్లై. ఐఎమ్ మార్కింగ్ ఆప్షన్ ఫర్ యూ 124.
సార్ నెట్ ఇష్యూ సార్.
ఎప్పుడు నెట్ ఇష్యూస్ వస్తూనే ఉంటాయా గంట సేపటికి కూడా? So UAP, universal immunization program, then comes vitamin A prophylaxis, then oral rehydration therapy, then acute respiratory infections to be taken care of, and anemia and outreach scheme. Okay, I told you about the outreach scheme also. So these are all the essential newborn care, safe delivery practices. Please do make a note of all these things. This slide is very very important. Please listen. Safe delivery practices. Cleaning of respiratory passages both through nasal and oral. Cleaning of eyes and skin. Recording the birth weight. Exclusive breastfeeding. Identification of at-risk babies. That means oligohydramnia, polyhydramnias, hydrops babies, Yeah, twin pregnancies, babies born to diabetic and hypertensive mothers. Okay, stillbirth babies, all the things should be taken care of. You have to identify at risk. Yeah, low birth weight. That's why you have to record the weight at the time of delivery also. Referral is also one of the important parcel of essential newborn care. So this is a short notes for you people. Baby friendly hospital initiative. Please do follow these things. BFHI, baby friendly hospital initiative. Previously used to be in your books, but now they have been removed or put it in somewhere else. But this is an important short notes for you people. Baby friendly hospital initiative. So what we have to do to maintain BFHI? Okay, so what we have to do is we have to communicate to all the staff on policy of exclusive breastfeeding. So we have to communicate all the staff members, whoever present in the pediatric ward or acute neonatal care. Okay, we have to explain the importance and policy of exclusive breastfeeding. Then we have to train them. First we have to teach them, then we have to train the staff in skills to encouraging the breastfeeding. Okay, then inform all pregnant women the benefits of breastfeeding. Okay, tell me some. So you people are placed in a neonatal care, you have to explain a pregnant woman regarding benefits of breastfeeding. Yeah, now tell me. ఇప్పుడు చెప్పు బాబు 124 రోల్ నెంబర్ 124
సార్ ప్రెసెంట్ సార్
చెప్పండి హౌ యు విల్ ఎంకరేజ్ ఎ ప్రెగ్నెంట్ ఉమెన్ సో దట్ షీ విల్ గివ్ ఎక్స్క్లూజివ్ బ్రెస్ట్ ఫీడింగ్ ఆఫ్టర్ డెలివరీ హౌ యు విల్ మోటివేట్ హర్ సో వాట్ ఆర్ ఆల్ ద బెనిఫిట్స్ యు విల్ టెల్ హర్ టెల్ మీ
సార్
benefits of breastfeeding
immunity increases immunity sir
it increases immunity to whom mothers or child
to child sir
very good so Sri Madhuri says
child
that
mother relationship
very good bonding that is called bonding Okay, very good Madhuri, maternal antibodies so that immunity is increased. Very good. So Isha says safe, cheap, high immunoglobulins, good diet. Very good, very good. Then what do you mean by lactational amenorrhea? Lactational amenorrhea, that is also one of the benefit by giving exclusive breastfeeding. Yeah, mother feels safe, baby feels safe, bonding will be increased, all the reflexes will be on time, hypopituitary thalamus line is also very good for a woman, suckling reflexes is also very good by giving breastfeeding. What do you mean by suckling reflex? Yeah, no ovulation at lactation. Very good Hitaishi, very good. Reshma Sri, very good. Low risk of breast cancer, very good. What do you mean by suckling reflex? Suckling reflex. Yeah. So whenever suckling reflex means whenever the due to chemotactic action of breast milk, the baby automatically will finds the mother's nipple. This is a natural way. Okay, yeah, very good, very good. Network issues. Am I slow? I mean, ni maatladedi chaala late ga vinpadutunda meeku.
No, sir, it's fine.
Fine kada? Yeah, okay. Fine. Okay. Suckling reflex means okay. Due to some chemotactical action, baby definitely will attracted to the nipple of the mother. Okay. Whenever the baby touches the nipple, automatically he sucks it. The baby sucks it. So whatever happened means the milk is already produced. So due mother thinks that so the baby wants milk, so I have to produce milk. So that is called ejection reflex. Automatically when the nipple is sucked, the milk is automatically ejected from the ducts. Okay, so this is the suckling action. Yeah, Praveena also said that pressing of palate makes the baby suck. Yeah, very good. That is also one of the component. Yeah, Hitesh, at the touch of the nipple, milk is produced. Yeah, all were corrected. Gayatri, Hitesh, Praveena. So everybody is corrected. Yeah, very good. Just remember, ejection. What do you mean by ejection reflex? What do you mean by suckling reflex? These two are very important. Whenever we evaluate the baby, whether the baby is breastfed or not, whether the baby reflexes are good or not, at the time of delivery, the only reflexes that we have to check is ejection reflex and suckling reflex. Okay, very good. Yeah, so practice rooming in. What do you mean by rooming in? What do you mean by rooming in? All these are part and parcel of baby friendly hospital initiative. Rooming in means, so whenever delivery happens, immediately baby will be taken into the newborn ICU, NICU. Yeah, very good, Rahitashi. Baby and mother should be kept in the same room. Very good. So whenever the baby is born, due to some clean practices, baby is immediately taken to the other room to clean up everything. But whenever the mother, after delivery, after we cleaning up the cord, after removal of everything from the uterus, we have to check for the bleeding. Okay, we have to check for any gauze pieces in the uterus. We have to clean the entire area, the perineal region, everything. I'm talking about normal delivery. Okay, after cleaning everything, we have to okay, injections and itching tarata, we will be taking the mother into the other room, that is postnatal ward. Okay, we will shift the mother from the delivery table to the postnatal ward. Immediately the baby should be placed besides the mother. Immediately after reaching the postnatal ward, whenever she just taken off from the delivery table, immediately you have to give her baby to her mother. Just putting the baby beside the mother. That is called rooming in. That is called rooming in. So what are all the advantages? What are all the advantages by the process called rooming in? Yeah, it decreases the depression, it decreases the postpartum psychosis. So mother can keep an eye on her baby. So whenever the baby is hungry, immediately she can breastfeed her. Yeah, affection. Affection means bonding. Bonding. Bonding will be increased. Yeah, reflexes are stimulated. Skin to okay. Hypothermia is also prevented by skin to skin touch. By contact, the mother to feel safe, the baby also feels safe. That is the importance of baby friendly hospital initiative, and we have to practice it at any cost. Please do keep all these things in your mind. No MD/MS knowledge is required for these things. MBBS knowledge is more than enough to treat a newborn baby and a just delivering mother. Okay. So this is good. Give newborn infants no food, drinks other than breast milk unless medically indicated. Okay, at any cost, do not feed the baby with artificial food or water. Only breast milk. Then encourage breastfeeding on demand. Some says still in some rural areas says more than four times is enough, five times is enough, only 3 times is enough. All these taboos should be removed. Encouraging the breastfeeding on demand, whenever the baby feels hungry, the mother should be able to breastfeed on demand. So whenever the baby requires, she should be able to give the milk. So if at all on the first day, second day, milk is not produced, don't worry. Tell the mother that do not worry, just keep on feeding. At one point of time, ejection reflex will be produced. Milk will be produced from the ducts. So that is the importance of ejection fraction. Due to some depression or due to some psychological conditions, mothers were not able to produce milk at the time of delivery, even after 2-3 days of delivery also. But she should take the baby and breastfeed. If at all no milk is also coming, the baby should be breastfed, taken to the breast. Slowly milk will be produced. So this is the thing we have to explain to the mother. And give no artificial teats, okay, or artificial pacifiers to the breastfeeding infants. Some may mimics this artificial teats, artificial pacifiers, okay. At any cost, up to 6 months, we should not feed all these things. Okay, no advertisement or promotional material or free products in the facility. These things will be very, very important. No advertisement of these pacifiers, okay, promotional materials or free products at rooming in facilities. Only exclusive breastfeeding. Then encourage mother to assist each other and to develop breastfeeding support groups. That is the most important. All the mothers should keep a group and they have to discuss among themselves, and this discussion should be encouraging. So they will talk about all the things, they will talk about all the advantages. If at all any disadvantages are there, they will make a note and take up to the doctor, and doctor will rectify all the doubts regarding breastfeeding. So this is baby friendly hospital initiative. Again, I am telling you people, this is an important short notes for you. At the time of Viva also, it is very, very important. Please do read about these things. Then national immunization schedule, you know, all the immunization schedule which has to be followed. Now what are all the things included, you know, all these things, please go through of national immunization schedule from birth to 16 years. So this is some regarding oral rehydration. Yes. Am I clear so far? Am I clear so far?
Yes, sir.
Very good. Very good. Amma lady reply abledo. Itaishi, yeah.
Yes, sir.
Very good, ma. Very good. So this is regarding oral rehydration solution. Okay, please go through all these things. Old one, new one, WHO one. But just remember the whatever the contents. Contents in a ORS packet. What are all the contents? Contents in a ORS packet. All these things. Sodium chloride, sodium citrate, potassium chloride, and glucose. Then we talked about RCH indicators. So we have been telling that we have to implement this, we have to implement that, we have to do this, we have to do that, we have to encourage regarding breastfeeding, we have to take care of essential newborn care, essential antenatal care, emergency care, obstetrical care. We are telling all these things, but how should we know that all the things we are implementing, whether going in a good way or in a bad way? So whether there is a excess of these things are there or shortage of these things are there, how we have to know? Means these are through indicators. So they are collectively named as RCH indicators. Please do remember, this is also an important essay notes for you. The question will be like this: what are all the RCH indicators you know? Please discuss any five of them. The question will be like that only. So the RCH indicators will be CBR, that is crude birth rate, then CDR, crude death rate, then GR, growth rate, then TFR, total fertility rate, then CPR, child, what do you mean by CPR? I forgot it. Then IMR, infant mortality rate, then child mortality rate, maternal mortality rate, immunization status of pregnant women and children. CPR, that means a couple production rate regarding family planning. No ray, no cardiopulmonary resection, Viji. That is not cardiopulmonary resection, okay? This is couple production rate. Vijita, clear? Good. Couple production rate. Then immunization status of pregnant women and children. Okay, antenatal registrations, antenatal checkups, safe delivery services. Then regarding institutional deliveries indicators, postnatal checkup indicators, anemia, STDs. All these things were the indicators of RCH. Ma gurtu pettukondi. You have to remember all these things and you have to explain any five among these. All the things were in your textbook only. Please go through all these things. In principles of epidemiology also, all these things were given. And even in the national health program under RCH, all these things were given. You have to go through it. Then, and terminological things which has been using in RCH, I will give you just a glimpse on these things. Full antenatal checkup means three antenatal checkups plus TT dose, both. TT doses means two TT doses and 100 iron folic acids. Then only it called full antenatal care or full antenatal checkups. Full ANC means It includes 3 antenatal checkups, 2 doses of TD and 100 tablets of iron folic acid. Then what do you mean by safe delivery? That means the delivery should be institutional or home delivery attended by a skilled personnel. That is called safe delivery. That is clean environment, environment regarding delivery. So pregnancy complications, so you all know these things: swelling of hands, feet, visual disturbances, bleeding, convulsions, weak or no movement of fetus, or abnormal presentation, HELLP syndrome, HELLP. Yes, anyone can explain HELLP syndrome? What do you mean by HELLP syndrome? ఫస్ట్ ఇయర్ లో వచ్చింటది ఎవరికి తెలీదా? హెచ్ఈఎల్ఎల్పి
హిమోలైసిస్
హిమోలైసిస్
ఎలివేటెడ్ లివర్ ఎంజైమ్స్ లో ప్లేట్లెట్ కౌంట్ లో ప్లేట్లెట్ కౌంట్
ఎలివేటెడ్ లివర్ ఎంజైమ్స్
లో ప్లేట్లెట్ కౌంట్
వెరీ గుడ్ మా Ma, these things are very important. At any point of time, you should not forget all these things. HELLP syndrome is an important factor whenever you people attending a antenatal woman. You have to keep all these things in your mind. Whenever you order for all the normal routine investigations, you have to look for these things. So what are all the indication, I mean what are all the signs and symptoms of hemolysis? How will you say that the person is having hemolysis or not? So what investigations you will tell for a hemolysis? ఏమీనా 246 కి వచ్చాడే ఆదిత్య హృదయ రామ్ అంట హెచ్బి యా వెరీ గుడ్ రే హిమోగ్లోబిన్ ఓకే టు నో దిస్ థింగ్ ద మెయిన్ థింగ్ ఈ షుడ్ బి ఈఎస్ఆర్ ఎరిథ్రోసైట్ సెడిమెంటేషన్ రేట్ దట్ ఈస్ ద థింగ్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు లుక్ ఫర్ ద ఇన్వెస్టిగేట్ ద సిమ్టమ్ కాల్డ్ హిమోలైసిస్ బాబు ఆదిత్య హృదయ రామ్ ఎవరు ఉన్నాడా రోల్ నెంబర్ 149 And roll number 49, Tejasri. Roll number 49 and roll number 149. Absent. Very good. ఓకే హెచ్బి బిలిరూబిన్ బిలిరూబిన్ ఓకే నో రేట్స్ ఈఎస్ఆర్ దట్ ఈస్ ద థింగ్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు లుక్ ఫర్ హిమోలైసిస్ ఎల్డిహెచ్ టోటల్ బ్లడ్ కౌంట్ ఓకే 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 ఆల్ దీస్ థింగ్స్ ఆర్ ఎసెన్షియల్ బట్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు లుక్ ఫర్ ఈఎస్ఆర్ ద మెయిన్ థింగ్ ఈస్ ఈఎస్ఆర్ సో దోస్ ఆర్ ఆల్ ద ప్రెగ్నెన్సీ complications. So what is the drug of choice at the time of eclampsia? Anyone? What is the drug of choice for eclampsia? I asked you so many times this question.
Magnesium sulfate, sir.
Very good, Ray. Super. Gayatri, super. Magnesium sulfate. Very good. Then delivery complications. That means premature labor, obstructed labor, and prolonged labor. You should know when it is called premature labor. Okay, when it is called prolonged labor. Then you should know what do you mean by obstructed labor. all the things are very, very important. Please go through your textbook. You will find all these things in your book. Then post delivery complications like high fever, low abdominal pain, lochia, discharging of these things, excessive bleeding and dizziness or severe headaches, all these things regarded as post delivery complications. So the all the thing, okay, RCH has been in, I told you, in a phased manner. It is implemented in a phased manner. So what are all the things we talked about is RCH phase one. So then we will be coming into RCH phase two. So what are all the major strategies in RCH two? Means same things but in a upgraded fashion. In RCH phase two, all the things are included which were there in RCH phase one, but in some upgradation. Okay, like in essential obstetrical care, they included institutional delivery and skill attendance at the delivery. So I told you emergency obstetric care. That means establishment of first referral units, that is FRUs, at sub-district level health institutions was taken up for providing emergency obstetrical care. So and so first referral units were there, and 13 different types of equipment were provided for carrying out the procedures like laparotomy, C-section, blood transfusion, newborn care, and anesthesia management. There are certain criteria for first referral units. Please do make a note the question. What are all the criteria for a first referral unit? This is a UG question and even PG question also. Please do make a note of it. In your textbook, it is a beautifully given. What are all the things to be satisfied when we call it as a first referral unit? Just like here given, they should be having laparotomy processes, cesarean sections, blood transfusions, newborn care, and anesthesia management also. And the strengthening of the referral system is also is included in, major strategies in RCH 2. So what are all the newer initiatives in RCH? This is training of MBBS doctors in life-saving anesthetic skills for emergency obstetrical care. You know that. Setting up for blood storage centers at FRUs. This is also in a very, very major new initiative. Blood banks. That is called blood banks. Then you know about Janani Suraksha Yojana. The main objective is to reduce the both IMR and MMR through encouraging delivery at health institution, focusing on below poverty line women. Then Vande Mataram scheme is also has been introduced. Then safe abortion service is also very, very important aspect from where maternal mortality rate should be decreased. So these are also included under first referral units. So medical methods of abortion and manual vacuum aspiration is also there. So what do you think the medical method of abortion? What do you mean by that? Anyone? What do you mean by medical methods of abortion? Up to first trimester, how will the abortion takes place? If at all,
use of drugs, sir. Use of drugs.
Use of drugs, like what? Like what? Suppose a mother came in 12 weeks of gestation. She says that it's an unwanted pregnancy or a failure of contraception. She is willing to go for MTP. So how will you suggest? What method you will suggest?
Mifepristone.
Mifepristone, very good. Mifepristone, how much dose? 1 mg. Yeah, Madhuri, very good. Mifepristone along with? Yes, Sujit, chapandi. Just mifepristone.
Misoprostol, sir.
Very good. We have to use a PGF, prostaglandin. PGF 2 alpha, that is misoprostol. Then only the abortion will become successful of 95%. If you use only mifepristone, it is no, I mean, will be useful, but somewhat complications will be there.
After 12 weeks, sir.
Very good. So many other drugs are also there, but just remember those two one. Okay. And then integrated management of neonatal and childhood illnesses, that is IMNCI. This is also an important newer initiative which has been included under RCH. IMNCI, yeah, mifepristone 200 mg. Very good, ma'am. Gayatri, very good. IMNCI is also important national health program that you have to remember. Please do read about IMNCI also, which includes ARI, diarrhea, measles, malaria and malnutrition that are responsible for childhood mortality and morbidity. So most of the sick children present with the signs and symptoms, more than one of these conditions, as you know it. Integrated approach always should be there. Cost effective and emphasizes on the prevention of diseases. You know that it is an Indian version of IMNCI. Okay, IMCI. Just remember IMNCI, integrated management of neonatal and childhood illnesses. Okay. So the center pillar of child health interventions, the highlights will be, it includes 0 to 7 days of age, so which incorporates national guidelines on malaria, anemia and immunization schedule. And the training of health personnel begins with the sick young infants up to 2 months, and it should be skill based. All the training personnel should be directed to these high risk group. Then it is national AP. So these are all the things which have been included in RCH. We discussed about all these things. Yeah, family planning, maternal health, child health and adolescent, cross-cutting issues. So IEC activities should be like this. Branding, involving of professional agencies, media, interpersonal communication, celebrity involvement, all these regarding breastfeeding, regarding immunization, all these things. So we talked about this. So this is a client oriented, target free. These are the program objectives. We talked about all these things, okay? Yeah, we talked about service packages for mothers, that is essential obstetrical care, which includes all these things. So emergency obstetrical care, which includes all these things. Same, okay, good. This is the importance of breastfeeding. We talked about this. So couple protection rate, that is to maintain eligible couple registers, to maintain family planning services among them. Yeah, this is one of the thing which you have to just a point mention in your textbook. All the midwife, training health personnel will be given from kit E to kit P. Okay, so which kit includes which one? So this is the thing. Kit E includes laparotomy, so all this mini laparotomy, IUD insertions, vasectomy, normal deliveries, uterine evacuation set, all these will be sets, and these are named like this. These are some targets or project relevant to MCH program. In phase two, I told you in an upgraded fashion, this phase two program of RCH came into option, and the components were these things only: essential obstetrical care, emergency obstetrical care, strengthening of the referral system. That is what I told you. First referral unit, FRU. Capacity building, improving the referral system, midwiferies, strengthening of midwiferies, innovative schemes, all the things we discussed. So newer initiatives also we discussed. So training and upgradation. Setting up a blood storage, Janani Suraksha Yojana, Vande Mataram scheme, safe abortion services, IMNCI, 24 hours functioning of PHCs regarding mainly of mother and child health care. Okay, training in anesthesia is also in main ops, important training aspect under newer initiatives. Blood storage facility, yeah, Janani Suraksha Yojana, we talked about these things. So how much money is given under Janani Suraksha Yojana? Under below poverty line countries and above poverty line countries, in rural areas and urban areas, enta istunaru right now? Any idea? Telusukovali Janani Suraksha, yeah, Vijita. 700 where below poverty line low countries or above poverty line countries, in rural areas or urban areas? In your textbook it is neatly given. Below poverty line low, below poverty line states low, rural lo entistaru, అర్బన్ లో ఎంత ఇస్తారు, మదర్ కి ఎంత ఇస్తారు, ఆశా వర్కర్ కి ఎంత ఇస్తారు? ఆల్ ద ఫిగర్స్ నీట్లీ గివెన్
సార్. ఓకే, వైట్ సింబల్, వైట్ సింబల్. ఓకే, మీరు బిబిసి కు కావాలి
వైట్ సింబల్. ఓ యే,
ఏంటి వైరస్ సింబల్? థౌజండ్ ఇన్ అర్బన్. ఓకే, send it to Asha. Okay, just go through your work, then you will go through your textbook, you will get to know all these things. Janani Suraksha Yojana, you have to memorize how much amount will be given to mother of rural areas and Asha of rural areas, how much money will be given to mother in urban areas and Asha worker in urban areas. Please go through all these things. So in a Vande Mataram scheme, this is a non-governmental organization. Yeah, they told that it's a voluntary scheme wherein any obstetric and gynec specialist, maternity, home can volunteer. Enrolled doctors will display Vande Mataram logo at their clinics. Iron folic acid tablets, oral pills, and TT injections, etc. will be provided for free distribution. That is the scheme of Vande Mataram. So referral transport also should be there. So this is the time even Anana Jyoti Prakash. Inka unda
और सर
येरा सुजीत అయిపోయినా ఫీల్ అంత ఓ చెప్తును ఓకే ఓకే సో వి విల్ స్టాప్ హియర్ బై నెక్స్ట్ క్లాస్ ఐ విల్ డీల్ అగైన్ విత్ ఆల్ దీస్ రిమైనింగ్ థింగ్స్ అండ్ వి విల్ రివైజ్ ఇట్ బట్ ఏదర్ వే యూ హ్యావ్ టు ప్రిపేర్ please go through of RCH program in your textbook please read then only you will get to know okay now are we clear so far am I clear
yes sir
very good okay now very good very good okay thank you for attending my class thank you for listening you can leave please take care of yourself
thank you sir
thank you
thank you thank sir you.
Thank you ma you can leave you can leave